What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another severe weather forecast here by Age of the Forecast here. In today's video, we're going to be looking at the big possibility for maybe a huge severe weather outbreak likely for the northern and central plains early into this week here. Also, going to be monitoring the severe weather as well likely for today, but the video is really mainly for the day three and possibly day four outlook here, where we can possibly see multiple chances for extreme tornadoes, damaging wind, and hail. We're gonna be looking at the timing and who could see the worst. But before we get into the video, I want to give a shout out to David Schlotthauer here for the idea of this intro here. I did like the idea and he gave me permission to use it, so I do want to give David a shout out here for this awesome intro idea here. So be sure to subscribe to David Schlotthauer if you have not already done so. But also be sure to hit the subscribe button for my channel as well to show your awesome support. Also hit the like button, also hit the post notification icon to get notified as soon as I make my awesome videos here so you are weather aware. But without further ado, let's get into the severe weather forecast video. So here's the day one outlook here, and as you see, we have a very widespread threat for severe weather. We actually have four regions under a slight risk here, so very widespread severe weather potential. We went right here into the northern and western plains, for including Montana, the Dakotas, and also Wyoming. Also have a slight risk here. That me and David Schlotthauer are really focusing on, where we can possibly see some very large hail, possibly a tornado probability, right here for Iowa, Nebraska, South Dakota, and Minnesota, and Wisconsin. This slight risk is my biggest area of focus here for today. I think we're going to be seeing very, very large hail. Would not rule out the possibility for an enhanced risk here. Our third slight risk is including portions of the southeast here, including the Carolinas, Virginia, Tennessee, almost into Georgia, Kentucky, and almost portions of Indiana and Illinois. And then our fourth is actually for the New England and northeastern region there, so very widespread slight risk, including portions near Greensboro, including Nashville, New York City, Concord, New Hampshire, Boston, Providence, Connecticut, Minneapolis, Waterloo, Des Moines, Bismarck, portions near Gillette, and also a lot more. So this is where we have severe weather today. We're not going to be talking about this the whole video. Actually, we're going to be talking about this very briefly. Like I said, this is where I have our really biggest tornado probability for today at a 5% chance right here. David thinks it could be a 10% chance, but I think the biggest probability for an upgrade is for the hail probability. So we have that 5% chance for tornadoes, including Minnesota, South Dakota, Nebraska, and Iowa. And then we have a hail probability here with two areas of 15% chance hatch risk. I think this could become a 30% chance hatch risk here for hail. I think we're going to be seeing very, very large hail, possibly baseball-sized hails likely for today. And then we have also a 15% chance hatch risk for that other area in the northern plains. So this area in the Midwest seems to be the worst of it today, as areas in the northeast only have a 5% chance for hail. Wind, very widespread. This is exactly why we have slight risk for the southeast and northeast due to the wind probability. Let's go and jump out all the way to the day three outlook. Like I said yesterday, this could very well become a very big threat here. Let me actually zoom in a little bit more here so you can actually see this a lot more. So this is where we have our big potential for severe weather on day three, which is going to be including the timeline of Tuesday to Wednesday. So that's from June 30th to July 1st. This is where we can definitely see extremely strong severe weather here. I think this could be enhanced by tomorrow and maybe, just maybe, a moderate risk by day one. I'm not going to rule out the possibility of a moderate risk due to all the models are encouraging this extreme severe weather here. We have a lot of low jet. We have the Cape values. We have the helicity numbers. We have everything's coming to play. We also have very warm temperatures, bringing in some high dew points and a lot of humidity. It just seems very favorable for the northern plains. This is day three here, including a slight risk for the Dakotas, Minnesota, and Nebraska. We have very, very widespread marginal risk here, as the probability is a 15% chance, so that is including a slight risk. Now, day four. Day four, like I've been mentioning yesterday, which was actually day five yesterday, I also think day four, or the 1st of July to the 2nd of July, is also very encouraging for severe weather. I think we can also have a back-to-back enhanced risk day here for the Midwest. Very big possibly for severe weather, including Wisconsin, a lot of Minnesota, Iowa, Nebraska, and the Dakotas. very big encouraging severe weather days. And also, we check the day five outlook here. Let's actually check out the day five outlook. It is going to be maintaining at a bit of a lower probability here as we wait. See, too low for severe weather here, as you see. But I would not rule out the possibility if we have maybe a marginal or slight risk by day five when it gets to the point. Here we are taking a look at the NAM3KM model here, and as we see, as I've been mentioning, we're going to be seeing some strong severe weather for the Midwest and Northern Plains today in those scattered slight risk regions. This is where I think we'll have our biggest probability right here for portions of Iowa, especially if we can possibly have an incoming squall line likely here, and possibly a very big squall line here. This is definitely bring an extremely large hail, maybe not as many tornadoes. We might have a spotty tornado or two, maybe a one or two tornado reports are likely for today, but the main threat is obviously going to be the hail probability, where we have that 15% chance hatch risk. And then we're also going to be seeing some strong storms for North Dakota as well today, but really Iowa is my main threat for today as well. David Schlotterher as well agrees, and then we'll have some of those incoming burst of severe weather going a lot more widespread now to Wisconsin and Nebraska. It's gonna be like a wall cloud formation here, like a U or like a little smile right there. And that's what's gonna be like really right there at that point. Also seeing that severe weather for portions of the Southeast and also Ohio Valley, where we have that other slight risk. But this isn't getting all the way into tomorrow morning. As we now get into the 30th of June, that's when things get very interesting for the Northern Plains here. 30th of June to July 1st is gonna be a huge threat here for severe weather. We have a defined low pressure system at 995 millibars there. As you see, really strong storms will develop later into the afternoon of June 30th here. Very strong system will develop. Could very well see squall lines here. Could very well see a linear system of very strong supercells. And that's going to really burst into North Dakota to portions of Nebraska. You're going to be seeing that as we get closer into that 60th hour mark. So July 1st is going to be really interesting here when it comes to the storms. So here we're taking a look at the Cape Valleys for today. As you see, very favorable conditions for severe weather today out here for portions of the Midwest, including the Iowa area. We're surpassing 5,000 joules per kilogram, a ton of energy there. Then we're seeing 5,300 joules per kilogram for portions of Nebraska, and maybe even surpassing the mid 5,000s here. 5,500 joules per kilogram is likely for portions of Nebraska and Iowa. Very widespread amounts of energy here, including instability, really, especially that humidity and overday heating. That's going to be coming to play while we have those very high Cape values here. As we now get into tomorrow, though, by the 30th here, or getting in, sorry, more to the 29th of tomorrow, not 30th. That amount of energy will die down a little bit. We're still seeing some decent numbers here. That's going to bring in some, possibly for some morning and early afternoon showers and T-storms. We're seeing some nice 2,700 to 3,000 joules per kilogram. As we now get to the night or the evening of the 29th, that's when the energy really blows up from portions of the South Central to the Midwest and Northern Plains, surpassing 5,000 joules per kilogram. And as we get into June 30th, look at these numbers by June 30th. Absolutely crazy. We're going to be seeing 4,000 plus joules per kilogram by Texas all the way to the Canadian border. Absolutely crazy amounts of Cape values here. So we're going to be seeing a very widespread threat for severe weather. But look at this. Getting very close to 6,000 joules per kilogram, really. Going to get 5,500, 5,800. Maybe we actually do have a 6,000 here at some point, but look at 6,031 joules per kilogram for the North Dakota and South Dakota border area. Very, very good amount of energy here in the exact areas where we had that severe weather threat for day three. Also, almost 5,000 joules per kilogram for Wisconsin, surpassing 5,000 joules per kilogram in Oklahoma, maintaining that very high amount of energy for the northern and actually a lot of the plains there. And then by July 1st, like I said, July 1st can be very interesting. Look at these amounts of numbers here. Look at these numbers for portions of the South Central and Central Plains, possibly surpassing 6,000 joules per kilogram right here, 5,900. And look at this, a very, very good number. And then for day four, we have that severe weather threat right here. We're going to be surpassing 3,000 and even close to 4,000 joules per kilogram at that point. And then by July 2nd, we have a huge skyrocketing number right here of Cape. So it looks like we're gonna be seeing a lot of severe weather incoming to the first days of July and last days of June. Very, very active here. Look at these numbers, absolutely crazy. 6,100, almost 6,200 joules per kilogram in that area right there. Absolutely crazy what this outcome is gonna be. And then look at this by July 3rd, and July 4th. So hope you guys did enjoy the cape right there. A huge presentation of all the way to July 4th of some numbers. But obviously, we're going to be focusing on that, on this severe weather for June 30th to July 1st to July 2nd. All right, everybody, here we're going to be taking a look at the helicity here. Obviously, helicity is the amount of spin in the atmosphere as well, also as indicating energy as well. And look at these numbers starting off by later today here into early tomorrow. We're going to be seeing already possibly 583 meters per second squared. It's actually a ton of spin in the atmosphere here. It's surpassing 623. Very high amount of helicity here. The more amount of helicity, the better the probability for severe weather. Look at June 30th. Look at this. A wave of extreme numbers of helicity incoming, a probability for obviously supercells and also QLCS, those here. Possibly 813 meters per second squared. Very, very high numbers there. 813 meters per second squared. Very, very nice amount of spin in the atmosphere there. And that's going to continue to head in into the North Dakota, into the Dakota area. And then by July 2nd, we have another higher number, some 300 and 400 meters per second squared, but really high, very high amount of helicity in the northern plains, expected at the exact same time as the severe weather. So looking very favorable, already helicity, cape, everything's going to plan. Let's go ahead and check out now the wind shear and the low level jet, and also the SCP. So here we are taking a look at the SCP here, the supercell composite parameter or composite parameter. So here we are looking at the really good numbers for supercells right here. This is measuring the probability of seeing supercells based on a graph. Anything higher than a 25 or anything higher than a 20 is considered a very good probability for seeing supercells. And that's exactly where we have the probability for tornadoes, hail, and damaging winds. Seeing some very good numbers already at 23 here, 22, maybe even 24 for a portion of the South Dakota area here, South Dakota Basin, by later today. Also 12, 15, some nice teens and higher teens for Iowa later today. Like I said, that's a main area of focus. And as you now get later into that June 30th and also July 1st, we'll be seeing some good numbers here, 15, even surpassing 30 for Kansas. So very high amounts of a decent probability, high probability for some supercells coming in into early next week, mainly including that Tuesday to Wednesday frame, maybe even Monday, but really big probability is going to be going all the way into portions of the St. Louis area and the Mississippi River Basin, also Ohio Valley. Last thing we'll be looking at is this low-level jet here. Obviously, the more wind shear, obviously, that bring increases that probability for some severe weather and incoming supercells. Obviously, when you have a low-level jet very strong, that's where you have the big probability for tornadoes. Example number one. Easter outbreak had a very impressive low level jet going this way like that. That brought an extreme amount of tornadoes for these areas out here into the southeast. May, we saw, I believe, very little enhanced risk, actually. I think we've had more enhanced risk, three times as more enhanced risk in June than in May. That is because in May we had one event of severe weather actually had a strong low level jet. The rest had no wind shear whatsoever, which is why we barely saw any tornadoes whatsoever. I think we saw less than 10 tornadoes in the month of May. I'm not exactly sure if that's accurate or around there. And this is completely different. Now we're seeing a very strong low jet and a lot of wind shear flow coming in, bringing in those southerly winds. That's going to bring in some nice severe weather potential. 80 knots here in the higher atmosphere, surpassing maybe 81 knots. And that's going to be exactly right in the areas of severe weather. Everything's adding up. Everything's adding up. Cape, helicity, wind shear flow. All that's adding up on the exact location of severe weather, which means very, very likely, very, very likely this could become something very interesting. 68, maybe 70 knots there, and then it kind of dies down by the time we get to July 2nd, which is the time zone where the severe weather kind of falls apart. Everything's adding up. But hope you guys enjoyed the video, and let's go ahead and end this and close this out. So I hope you guys did enjoy the video. Please smash the subscribe button as well to show your awesome support as we close this video. Also, smash the like button, try to get the 20 likes here to show your awesome support so I know you guys love the severe weather forecast. Also, smash that bell notification icon so you get notified as soon as I post a daily upload. Also, be sure to check out David Schlotheimer as well. He's the inspiration of this intro here, this new intro and also outro. Go ahead and check out his channel. He has awesome uploads there. But hope you guys did enjoy the video, and bye, guys.